no bottle of water.
I need a bottle, a big bottle of water.
Thank you.
have any wine on the Bema tonight?
It's all good.
And I told the choir to be ready to enter at about 5 minutes to seven, because I want them seated before we start.
Yeah.
They've
got to see it. Long time no show. What happened to me?
No, tomorrow. I brought mine too. A young
next
choir.
Friday night.
Yeah.
Next Friday night. Well, I will be.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good Yontif, everyone. If we could get everybody to sit and take their seats, please, that would be wonderful. We'll wait a minute or so for everyone to come in and get settled.
Would the ushers please close the doors?
Just wait for the last few people. Thank you. Thank you. Shalom. Good Yontif. Welcome. My name is Jackie Rosen, and I am president of this amazing congregation. And I thank you for coming here tonight to share the new year with all of us. We begin with an opening song, Hallelujah. At this time, I would like to invite Janet Duda, Michelle Blank, and Cindy Jensen to come up for the blessing of kindling the lights of Yom Tov and Shehekianu, the prayer that thanks God for sustaining us and enabling us to reach this season. Please turn to page 17 in your prayer books.
Okay. creator of the beginnings, as you create the world on this day, uniting fragments into a universe, so help unite our hearts and the hearts of all Jews to serve you. Illuminate our lives with the light of your Torah, for by your light do we see light. Grant us this year a glimpse of the light of redemption, the light of healing and of peace. Amen.
Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kiddushonu b'mitzvotav, l'tivanu lehadlan shner shel yom tov. Blessed is the Lord our God, ruler of the universe, who hallows us with mitzvot and commands us to kindle the lights of Yom Tov.
Blessed is the Lord our God,
ruler of the universe, for giving us life, for sustaining us, and for enabling us to reach this season.
Baruch Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, shehechianu v'kiyamanu v'higianu l'zman hazeh.
Will the congregation please rise?
Page 19. Behold me of little merit, trembling and afraid, as I stand before you to plead for your people, O gracious God, the one enthroned by Israel's praises. Dear God of compassion and love, accept my petition and that of my people. Let them not be put to shame because of me, nor I because of them. Sinners though we are, let our prayers come before you, innocent and sweet and pleasing, as though from hearts more worthy than ours. Let love be the banner we raise in your sight, and let that love conceal all our sins and make them as though they had not been. Change our afflictions to joy and gladness, our misdeeds to acts of life. May our love of truth and peace remove all that hinders us from sincere and fruitful prayer. O God Supreme, God of every age, God eternal, let my prayer find favor for the sake of the righteous, the loyal, the honest, and upright, and for the sake of your own glorious purpose on earth. For you are the one who in mercy hears our prayer. Blessed are you who hearkens to prayer. And let us say, Amen. Please be seated. Good Yontif, everyone. It is good for us to come together as a community to share the Bima with Cantor Jessica Hutchings, to be with all of you as we greet the new year, to celebrate in song and in prayer. May this year be especially sweet for us all. May we find blessing in our friendships, in our sense of family, and most assuredly our faith. We continue in our worship on page 20. Hear me, Jacob, Israel, whom I have called. I am the one, the beginning and the end. My own hand founded the earth and spread out the skies. Thus says the Eternal One who created the heavens and stretched them out, who made the earth and all that grows in it, who gives breath to its people and spirit to those who walk on it. Thus says the Eternal One, Creator of heavens, the One who is.
I am, I will be, there is none else. Justice is my speech, right my declaration. The troubled past is forgotten, hidden from my sight.
For behold, I create a new heaven and a new earth, the past forgotten, never called to mind. Be glad then and rejoice forever in my creation. God of our people, hear our prayer. We who speak are Jews. Remember the bush you kindled once in the desert air, years ago on Horeb's lonely sand. That fire you lit to set the centuries aflame and say to us your endless, perfect name. I am what I will be. It burns eternally now, that light, upon our altars now, against the night. And there are deserts still. We are the Jews. We do not forget.
Remember the words you spoke in stone and thunder.
The mountain smoked, and the dismayed multitude stood off, hearing the first time the words they could not refuse, fearing the burden and the God that set them into history. And there are mountains still. We are the Jews. We cannot forget. We come here then, but something far more deep compels. The ancient desert dream we keep, the people touched by God, a certain grace that tells of you. We are locked with you, an old identity, remembering the lightning of that place, something in us of your awesome will, something of that mountain's thunder still.
Love us as much as you like you. You are your Jews. We will not forget you.
In the seventh month, on the first day of the month, there shall be a sacred assembly, a cessation from work, a day of commemoration proclaimed by the sound of the shofar. Let us rise. Sound the shofar when the new moon appears, at the turning of the year, at the returning of our solemn celebration. For this is a statute binding on Israel, an ordinance of the God of Jacob.
Jacob. Yehi ratzon milfanecha, Adonai Eloheinu v'Elohe avoteinu, shetchadesh aleinu ve'al kol beit Yisrael et hashanah hazot, shenat chameshet alafim ushva meot ushvim v'chamesh lechayim ulshalom, lesason usimcha, lishua ulnechama, v'nomar
May it be your will, eternal Lord God, God of all generations, that the year 5775 bring to us and the whole house of Israel life and peace, joy and exaltation, redemption and comfort, and let us say, Amen. Please be seated. We read together, Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, Asher Bidvaro Ma'ariv Aravim, Bechokhma Poteach Sha'arim, Uvitvuna Meshene Itim, Umachalif Et Hazmanim, Umesader HaKochavim B'mishmroteim Barakia Kirtzono, Borei yom v'layla golel or mipnei choshech v'choshech mipnei or. V'mavir yom v'mevi layla v'mavdil ben yom v'vein layla Adonai tzva'ot shemo. El chai v'kayam tamid yimloch aleinu le'olam va'ed. Baruch ata Adonai hama'ariv aravim. There was silence, there was chaos, there was a voice. A mind went forth to form worlds. Now order reigns where chaos once held sway.
The law makes evening fall. The law brings on the dawn.
The moon follows accustomed paths, constellations, their patterned ways. Sovereign is the will that orders the stars in their courses in the endless skies. Sovereign is that will. And how unyielding is the will of our people Israel. After the long nights, after the days and years when our ashes blackened the sky, Israel endures, heart still turned to love, soul turning still to life.
So day and night, early and late, we will rejoice in the study of Torah. We will walk by the light of mitzvot. They are our life and the length of our days. Praise be the source of life and love, and Israel, our people.
Let us rise.
Sharon O'Keefe. etzavecha, ayom alevavecha, vishinantam levanecha, vidibartabam, beshivtecha, bebetecha, uvlechtecha, vaderech, uvishochbecha, uvikumecha, ukshartam leot al yadecha, behayule totafot, beinecha, uchtatam, al mezuzot betecha, uvisharecha, leman tizkeru, va'asitem et kol mitzvotai, vitem kedoshim, leloheichem, ani. Adonai Eloheichem, Asher hotzeiti etchem, me'eretz Mitzrayim, lihiot lachem l'Elohim, ani Adonai Eloheichem.
You shall love the Lord your God with all your mind, with all your strength, with all your being. Set these words which I command you this day upon your heart. Teach them faithfully to your children. Speak of them in your home and on your way. When you lie down and when you rise up, bind them as a sign upon your hand. Let them be a symbol before your eyes. Inscribe them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates. Be mindful of all my mitzvot and do them. So shall you consecrate yourselves to your God. I, the Lord, am your God, who led you out of Egypt to be your God. I, the Lord, am your God.
What does it mean to be a Jew? You shall be holy.
In the face of the many, to stand for the one, in the presence of fragments, to make them whole.
What does it mean to be a Jew?
You shall be a holy people.
To hold fast to our religion of truth, to retain our faith in tomorrow.
Holy in our past is the memory of redemption from Egyptian bondage. Twice holy in our past are those who gave their lives to hallow this world.
Holy is the Jew today and tomorrow, who bears witness to the goodness of life.
And holy are those whose lives are songs in freedom's cause.
Adonai, mi kamocha, netar b'kol.
we lie down this night in peace and rise up to life renewed. May night spread over us a shelter of peace, of quiet and calm, the blessing of rest. There will come a time when morning will bring no word of war or famine or anguish. There will come a day of happiness, of contentment and peace. Praise be the source of joy within us, for the night and its rest, for the promise of peace.
It gadol ve'it kadash shemer rabba.
Amen.
Ve'alma tivrach yutei ve'yablich malchutei b'chayechon uv'yom mechon u'b'chayei decho b'it Yisrael b'agalav izman kariv ve'ymeru. V'yitpa'ar, v'yitramam, v'yitnaseh, v'yithadar, v'yitaleh, v'yitalal, shemei dekodesha.
Yeah.
Tapa 32. Atah kadosh v'shimcha kadosh, ukdoshim b'chol yom, yucholucha sela. You are holy, your name is holy, and those who strive to be holy declare your glory day by day. You may be seated. O Lord our God, cause all your works to stand in awe before you, and all that you have made to tremble at your presence. Let all that lives revere you, and all creation turn to you in worship. Let them all become a single family, doing your will with a perfect heart. For well we know, O eternal our God, that yours is the majesty, yours the might, and awesome is your name in all creation. Grant honor, Lord, to your people.
Glory to those who revere you, hope to those who seek you, and courage to those who trust you. Bless your land with gladness and fill you with joy, and cause the light of redemption of dawn all who dwell on earth.
Then the just shall see and exult, the upright be glad, and the faithful sing for joy. Violence shall rage no more, and evil shall vanish like smoke. The rule of tyranny shall pass away from the earth, and you alone, O God, shall have dominion over all your works, as it is written.
The Lord shall reign forever.
You are holy, awesome is your name. There is no God but you, as it is written.
The Lord of hosts is exalted by justice. The holy God is sanctified by righteousness.
Baruch atah Adonai HaMelech HaKadosh. Blessed is the Eternal, the Holy King. In love and favor, O God, you have chosen us from all the peoples, hallowing us with your mitzvot. Our sovereign, you have summoned us to your service, that through us your great and holy name may become known in all the earth. In your love, O God, you have given us this day of remembrance, to hear the sound of the shofar, to unite in worship and to recall the exodus from Egypt. Our God and God of all ages, amen.
This day bless us to
live. Amen.
This day help us to live. Amen.
Our God and God of our ancestors, may you rule in glory over all the earth, and let your grandeur be acclaimed throughout the world. Reveal the splendor of your majesty to all who dwell on earth, that all your works may know you as their maker, and all the living acknowledge you as their creator. Then all who breathe shall say, the Eternal God of Israel is the ruler whose dominion extends to all creation. Our God and God of our ancestors, I ask with your mitzvot, and let your Torah be our way of life. Satisfy us with your goodness, gladden us with your salvation, and purify our hearts to serve you in truth. For you, O God, are truth, and your word is true forever. Blessed is the Eternal who hallows the house of Israel in the day of remembrance. Be gracious, O God, our God, to your people Israel, and receive our prayers with love. O may our worship always be acceptable to you. Fill us with the knowledge that you are near to all who seek you in truth. Pour out your spirit upon us. Let our eyes behold your presence in our midst and in the midst of our people in Zion. Baruch atah Adonai HaMachazir Shechinato L'Tzion. We gratefully acknowledge that you are the Lord our God, and God of our people, the God of all generations. For all these, O sovereign God, let your name be forever exalted and blessed, and let life abundant be the heritage of all the children of your covenant. O God, our Redeemer and Helper, let all who live affirm you and praise your name in truth. O Eternal, whose nature is goodness, we give you thanks, and we give you praise. Grant us peace, your most precious gift. Within its homes, strengthen the bonds of friendship among the inhabitants of all lands. May the love of your name hallow every home and every heart. We'll take a few moments now for a Misha Berach, a prayer of hope, of healing, and of faith. We think of those who minister to others, who are caregivers for those who are ill. We ask that God grant them patience and hope and courage. We think of those who are chronically ill, and we turn to God to embolden them with strength as well, that they may not only endure, but that they may feel present in life itself. And for our loved ones, and for those who struggle with addiction and sobriety and so many other things. Our hearts turn to you, O God, to grant them strength of will and a body and healing of spirit, of soul, and a body. If you would like to say the name of someone or people close to you, please stand at this time and say as many names as you would like. Now we as a community, we rise in solidarity with them as we join as a community in singing Misha Berach. Take time for a few moments of silent prayer. page 40. It's that powerful prayer known as Avinu Malkeinu, which we beseech God to hear our voice, our prayers, to open up the gates, even as we ask, please God, open up our hearts, to find a sense of forgiveness and redemption, to find wholeness of spirit in our relationships with God, with those in our family. As we greet this prayer, I ask Yvonne and Jerry Gordon, Charlene and Ron Ostrove, Gwen and Jim Mason to come forward for the honor of accompanying the ark curtains as they are open. Page 40, would the congregation please rise?
Avinu Malkeinu Shema Kolenu.
Our Father, our King, hear our voice.
Avinu Malkeinu Chatanu Lefanecha.
Our Father, our King, we have sinned against you.
Avinu Malkeinu Chamol Aleinu Ve'al Olaleinu Ve'tapenu.
Our Father, our King, have compassion on us and on our children.
Avinu Malkeinu Kale Dever Ve'cherev Ve'ra'av Me'aleinu.
Our Father, our King, make an end to sickness, war, and famine. Avinu Malkeinu, kalei kol tzar u'mastin mi'aleinu.
Our Father, our King, make an end to all oppression.
Avinu Malkeinu, kotveinu b'sefer chayim tovim.
Our Father, our King, inscribe us for blessing in the Book of Life.
Avinu Malkeinu, chadesh aleinu shana tova.
Our Father, our King, let the new year be a good year for us.
Avinu Malkeinu, harem keren Yisrael amecha.
Our Father, our King, give strength to your people Israel.
Avinu Malkeinu Chanenu Va'anenu Ki Ein Banu Ma'asim Asei Manu Tzedaka Ve'chesed V'hoshienu.
Our Father, our King, be gracious and answer us, for we have little merit. Treat us generously with kindness and be our help.
Avinu Malkeinu Shema Koleinu Avinu Malkeinu Chatanu Lefanecha
Gentif, everyone. Before I even get started, how's the sound this year? I'm going to tempt fate because we may get feedback on the sermon. But they worked so hard. It sounds so great. The choir sounds beautiful. The voice of our new cantor just gorgeous. It's really a beautiful, beautiful evening. So we celebrate together a new year, a new beginning. So there's an old Jewish joke about a young couple who just had their first child. In their excitement, they proudly send out their birth announcements to all of their friends. Sarah and David Cohen proudly announced the birth of their son Danny on October 7th, 2014. Danny is slated to graduate medical school in the spring of 2042. There are variations of this joke, of course, most all of them focusing on the ethnic pride we have in our children in general, being so brilliant, being financially successful. But in our humor, there is more than a grain of truth of values hidden and values revealed. We exalt certain professions. We exalt certain attributes of success, of getting ahead in life. But perhaps we would do better to exalt certain values. When we ask a little child what he or she hopes to be when they grow up, we expect an answer like a policeman, a fireman, an attorney, a doctor, a businessman. But never does it occur to us that our expectations should be somewhat different. In other words, perhaps we should worry less about what our children do for a living and more about who our children are while they are living. And by the way, this is more than just an academic exercise. It is really at the heart of our vision for our children and ties inextricably with our Jewish communal sense of self. To make my point clear, if we want our children to become doctors, we know we have to raise them to be academically inclined, to teach them to take their studies seriously, expose them to math and science, and the importance of being dedicated to their work. But how do we act if we want our children to grow up and become good Jews? That path seems less clear today than at any time in history. I'm not talking about Orthodox Jews. They have a very clear understanding of what it takes to raise a Jewish child and to instill Jewish values. But we are not Orthodox. We want the best of both worlds. We live in a world in which having a bagel and shmir and attending shul once a year is enough to sustain us. And perhaps it does. But unfortunately, it won't be enough to sustain our children. It is no secret that a growing segment of our population, especially those in their 20s and 30s, refer to themselves as spiritual. Tribalism holds little hold on their loyalties, and Jewish practice is often foreign. Particularism is counter to their sensibilities because the world in which they live is one that elevates and celebrates universalism. In fact, to this group, particularism seems to be chauvinistic or narrow-minded at best, and perhaps even the root cause of mankind's struggle with one another at worst. In short, we have not done as good a job as we could have to show and explain and teach our children what we want their Jewish future to look like. Let me invite you into a typical discussion I might have with the parent who's concerned with his child, that his child has no interest in being Jewish, even though he gave his son a bar mitzvah. Rabbi, I did for my son more than my parents did for me. I never had a bar mitzvah. We couldn't afford one. I gave my son a bar mitzvah, and now he doesn't do anything Jewish. So I asked, did he continue his Jewish education after his bar mitzvah? Well, no, I let him decide. He decided not to. Well, did you send him to a Jewish camp? Well, no, he goes to a sports camp. Well, how about in the home, do you celebrate any of the Jewish holidays? Well, no, his grandparents died, and we used to go over there for the holidays. So how do you expect your son, the bar mitzvah, to practice his Judaism? In fact, you have not done for your son what your parents did for you. For you, they gave a sense of belonging, a sense of community. You have given your son a ceremony without context. Judaism is not an event, but a series of sacred moments informed by our values and beliefs. So let me ask you something else. Do you want your son to go to college? Of course, Rabbi. Does your son know this? Of course he does. Well, how does he know that? Well, I tell him all the time to study. I try and impress upon him the importance of getting good grades. I plan to take him to see different colleges when he's in high school. And quite frankly, we talk about it all the time. You know, you're going to this school, you're going to be doing this, you're going to be studying. We talk about it. And at that moment, a light bulb goes off over his head. He now understands my point. Our children value what we teach them to value, and what we show them has value. A tallis given at a bar mitzvah but never worn, placed carefully inside a tallis bag and then put in storage, teaches a mixed message. The tallis is important. Keep it safe. But it also says, keep it locked away, for there is no use for it now. A few weeks ago, I delivered a sermon entitled, When Does the Next Gen Become This Gen? In this sermon, I pointed out one of the great ironies of the 21st century is that we live at a time when Jews on the whole are the most educated that they have ever been in secular education, and yet perhaps the most ignorant in Jewish education. We have always valued education. It is ironic that our value, though, has shifted from religious to solely secular education. There are those who decry the high rate of intermarriage, but as Rabbi Schulweis pointed out decades ago, today's couples are interfaithless. They lack a strong sense of any faith, but embrace a concept of wanting to be more spiritual. Some fall into New Age religious patterns, others dabble in lots of stuff, but no religious movement in particular. They go through the internet finding ideas about energy sources and mysticism and harmony, which they hope will bring them harmony and peace. And for many, it does. It works. But what is lacking, and what I think the next geners are searching for, is the same thing all of us desire: a sense of community, a sense of belonging. There are many young people, typically teens, who claim to have a wonderful social life. It is, however, all online. "I have hundreds of friends on Facebook," one of them told me with great pride. "I talk to them all the time." I asked, "Well, how often do you see them?" "Well, mostly never," came the reply. Worried parents wondered why their son didn't go outside and play ball or engage in more social activities. Their son explained that having virtual friends was enough for him. And perhaps it was. But I suspect that it wasn't. I suspect that even at a young age, or perhaps especially at a young age, the need to be with friends, with flesh and blood people, is pretty important. One person from NextGen remarked that when they lived out of town, viewing all the happenings of friends and family on Facebook actually made them feel more isolated, more homesick. They knew deep down that they wanted to be apart, not virtually, but here and now, in person. I'm going to risk going against the writings of many who feel that the next gen somehow isn't joining or being a part of our community because they don't care, that they think about religion differently and are distracted by technology and have little use for organized religion. I think that what truth there is in this statement is a reflection of the fact that the ties that traditionally bound people to religion early on, namely marriage and having children, has been delayed by at least 10 years. Whereas people traditionally went from their parents' homes to their own homes and had children by their early 20s, we know for the most part parents today are in their 30s, early 40s, or they don't get married at all. It is that distance which has created a vacuum and disconnect of experiences. Religion, whether it is Judaism or Christianity or Islam, is centered around the family. And singles often do not feel that pull to practice in a community because they don't feel that they belong. And their priorities lie in finishing school and building their careers. All this goes to state that it is not that there is no interest in organized religion. Rather, it is that the relevancy of organized religion has been delayed. Perhaps I'm only splitting hairs, but I don't think so. I think that what is needed are more programs to continue to tie our young adults to traditional Jewish values and to the community, and in the meantime, simply be patient. Worry less and welcome more. If there is an attraction to so-called spiritual directions, it is because those techniques can be practiced easily outside organized religious life. And it is a reflection of the weakened sense of particularism, which so defined the Jewish community for generations. As a people, we have been smothered by acceptance for the most part. And in our zeal to be accepted, we willingly gave up that which made us different and special. And so I'm going to present a challenge to you these High Holy Days. And this challenge goes for everyone here, no matter what your age or stage of life. I want you to think about yourself. I want you to think about your children, about your family, and your family values. I want you to think about how you know and how your children and how your grandchildren know Judaism is important. What is it that you do? What is it that you talk about? And if it isn't enough, ask yourself if you are willing to make some changes in your life. They don't have to be huge changes. I'm not asking you all to enroll your children in the yeshiva. I'm not asking you to give up your bagels and shmir. But I am asking you to get off the fence and stand up for the values that you profess are important. And too often, hope will endure through some mysterious spiritual inertia. I'm asking you to care about your spiritual and religious life as much as you care about your secular and professional life. For it is time. Time to find that which is lost. Time to reclaim that which has been discarded. Time to cherish that which was sacred. To make your own that which belonged to your forebears. It is time. As Hillel said 2,000 years ago, if not now, when? Gajanta.
Gifts and we are blessings, we are history in song, we are hope and we are healing, we are learning to be strong, we are words and we are pictures of the past. We are carriers of wisdom, not the first and not the last. L'dor v'dor nagid God lecha. L'dor v'dor we protect this chain. From generation to generation, the Dor V'Dor, these lips will praise your name. Looking back on the journey that we carry in our hearts, from the shadow of the mountain to the waters that would part, we are blessed and we are holy, we are children of your way, and the words that bring us meaning, we will have the strength to say. L'dor v'dor, nagid God lecha. L'dor v'dor, we protect this chain. From generation to generation, L'dor v'dor, these lips will praise your name.
Page 42, we have the blessings over the wine, the challah to wish us the sweetness and joy in the new year. Go ahead. We have our Bema guests join us. And those who are ushers, please come up on the Bema. We want to thank you as well. If you are an usher tonight, please join us for Kiddush.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei pri hagafen. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher bachar banu mikol am v'romamanu mikol ashon v'kidishanu b'mitzvotav v'titen lanu Adonai Eloheinu be'ahava et yom hazikaron hazeh yom truah mikra kodesh Zecher letziat Mitzrayim, kivanu v'acharta, ve'otanu kidoshta mikol ha'amim. Udvarcha am emet, ve'kayam la'ad, baruch ata Adonai, melech al kol ha'aretz, mekadesh Yisrael, ve'yom hazikaron.
I want to invite one more person up for Motzi. Jim Watkins, would you please join us? He is half of our sound duo, Joey Unger, who's now flown back to Arizona. And Jim have spent literally several days rewiring, replacing, reorganizing the sound. And I just want to acknowledge the contribution he's made. So thank you so much, Jim. Thank you very much. And for that, we give him a little piece of challah. We're so generous.
Don't worry, I gave him some apples That's and right. honey, too.
That's right. He works for challah.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Amotzi lechem min haaretz. Amen.
We'd like to call upon Marcy and Jack Simon, Janie and Jeff Gale and Harrison, Susan Fine, Max Spilka, for the honor of accompanying the Ark curtains as we open them for the Aleinu on page 72. Would the congregation please rise. Let us adore the ever-living God and render praise unto him who spread out the heavens and established the earth, whose glory is revealed in the heavens above, and whose greatness is manifest throughout the world. He is our God, there is none else.
Thank you.
We turn to our Kaddish prayer found on page 73. We recall those who have died in recent days: Jack Snyder, Leo Michelson, Lorelei Voynich, Nikki Devine, Sylvia Price, Martin Lazar, Marilyn Arco, Alexander Stein, Carol Hecht. With the preciousness of memory, we recall the Yahrzeits of Barbara Allen, Sidney Barish, Herbert Blank, Joseph Blaustein, Annie Cohn, Stanley Dreyfus, Louise Rose Ewing, Joanne Fredrickson, Annette Friedman, Julia Garcia, Nelson Leonard Goldberg, Sadie Greenberg, Abraham Haptor, John Healy, David Hurwit, Irvin Hinden, Thomas Lee Hoffman, Benjamin Hollander, Abraham Jacobs, Evelyn Judd, Irving Kestenbaum, Jerome David Mack, Pauline Markson, Bernie Matisau, Mildred Myers, Ann Miller, Pepe Malasky, Sophie Coplin Oliver, Joseph Polinsky, Nat A. Premsalar, Joseph Premack, Charlotte Ray, Holly Roberts, Dorothy Roth, Winifred Roth, Herman Settle, Esther Shever, Seymour Seymour, Deborah Winner James. If you would like to recall the name of a loved one who died, whose Yahrzeit was not mentioned, please stand and say their name. As we think of these and others who have touched our hearts, we rise to recite our Kaddish prayer. Yit kadal v'yit kadash shemei rabah v'yalma divrachi rutei v'yamlich machutei v'chayichon v'yamechon v'chayedachol be'Yisrael v'agala v'zman kari v'yamru amen v'heshmei rabah mevorach l'olam omeil maya Yet Barach, Vishtabach, Vipar, Vitramam, Vietnase, Vietadar, Vietale, Vitalal, Shmeid Kusha, Brichu, Leila Minkol, Birchata, Vishirata, Tushbechata, Venechemata, Dami Ram, Vyama, Vimru, Amen, Yeheshlam, Araba, Min Shamaya, Vachayim, Halena, Vialkol, Yisrael, Vimru, Amen, Ose Shalom, Vimramav, Huya, Ose Shalom, Aleinu v'alkol Yisrael v'imaru. Amen. May the source of peace send peace to all who mourn and bring comfort to all who are bereaved among us. Let us say, Amen. Please be seated. In a moment, I'm going to call upon our temple president for a word of Yontif greeting. But before I do, I just want to express another note, pun included, intended, of thank you. So going back about 2.5 years, I think, we had a death in the congregation, and I did the funeral, and we became friendly, and we got to talking. She said, you know, I know you work out, Rabbi, and one of my neighbors trains. And I said, well, you know, it's worth a try. So I go to one of her neighbors, and in his home, he's got these people coming in and out, and we just have fun. We talk a little bit about working out, a little bit about the weather, sometimes religion, you never know. And that was Ricky. Years go by, we become friends, and we need a choir director because Lillian retired. And I knew that Ricky, in addition to training, in addition to teaching karate, in addition to that, toured as an accomplished pianist in his life.
So knowing that his good Mormon tradition prepared him for this Jewish service, we decided to take a chance. And it started with he was going to, play for the High Holidays. And I told him, this is like a big deal. This is the World Series of Jewish prayer. He says, no problem, Rabbi. I got it covered. And this is like maybe the middle of May. And I said, I'm going to get you a choir director, because our choir director retired. And of course, we also have a new cantor who has new music and different ideas. And I think it was on our second rehearsal that the choir director decided to move to another state. So Ricky says, you know what, I can do both. And I think he's done an incredible job, don't you? So we are very, very appreciative to you, Ricky. You've made us all very proud. And our choir, our first rehearsal when we had a minion, and I prayed, God, that we would grow. In fact, I was going to volunteer for the choir. Little by little, or as we say, yittle by yittle, it grew in stature and in song, and our cantor worked so well with them to really make our service this evening a beautiful one. So thank you very, very much, choir. We really appreciate you. So there's my thank you for the entire season, because I know you guys are going to do great, and I'm stealing a little bit of Jackie's thunder, but we're just so proud of all of you, and I just wanted that to be said. And a little bit of behind the scenes of how God sometimes works in mysterious ways, even in working out. And the only president who would appreciate that is Cal Lewis. Where are you, Cal? Right? He's the one who said, Rabbi, you got to work out, and now I know why. So we could find a choir director. There you go. All right, Jackie, please.
Now, Rabbi, you're always a hard act to follow, but tonight you've made it really hard. And they gave me announcements as long as your sermon, so I'm really in trouble here. But I do want to thank everybody on behalf of the Temple Board and the membership. I thank our BEMA guests, Dr. Gary Cantor, Jackie Walton, the wonderful and fabulous Della Costa. Our choir, you sound amazing. Ricky, wonderful. Cantor and Rabbi, just a beautiful, beautiful service. Really, really appreciate it. There's so many people to thank during the High Holidays. A special thank you to the Men's Club, the Sisterhood, all of our volunteers who are going to help greet and seat you and do everything over the course of these next High Holy Days. So I will not say all their names, but we'll put them in a poster in the main lobby, and you can see them there. There's a few special Save the Date events that are coming up that I don't want people to miss. Coming up after Yom Kippur, of course, is Sukkot, and we have sushi, sake, and suds in the sukkah. Say that fast three times. On October 11th, we had 120-some people here last year in the patio. It was a lot of fun, so please come for that. And on Sunday, November 9th, we have a big education fundraiser. We're talking about the door and our kids. This is honoring Selma Bartlett, who's established an education fund for us in our preschool. And again, honoring Dr. Gary and Lynn Cantor for all their generous support of our education programs through the years. So it's a great event, and you can support our education. I'll go on to the schedule for tomorrow and the second day of Rosh Hashanah. They're listed on your high holiday tickets. But just so you know, 9 o'clock, preschool family service. That's where you want the babysitting, right? You need the babysitting right there, right after preschool. No tickets are required for that. 10 a.m., we have our traditional service and youth programs. So if your children are attending youth program K through 5, their check-in begins in the Cantor Library at 9:35. And after services, 1:15 p.m., we have Tashlik at the service at Cornerstone Park, which is the new wonderful park over on Wigwam and just about between Arroyo Grande and Stephanie, and that should be wonderful. Box lunches will be there. Bring your own lunch and bring some bread. So again, I thank you, Hashanah Tova, Rabbi Cantor.
Thank you, Jackie. By the way, as long as we're doing thank yous, real quick,
I have rarely seen someone work as many hours in his heart as our temple president, Jackie Rosen. So we gotta give Jackie a hearty. All of our temple presidents work hard. They all do a great job. Jackie, I think she put a bed here and she sleeps overnight. I mean, she's here all the time and you just are wonderful. Thank you, Jackie. Don't forget, on Sunday, there is a tradition of visiting the grave of loved ones between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. It's called a Kever Darot ceremony at King David. I will be there at 1 o'clock, as well as our cantor and some community rabbis and cantors, and we have a special ceremony called Kever Darot. And then afterwards, we go to graveside and we visit loved ones. And that's part of the tradition of this time period. And don't forget, we got to do Jewish, which means it's our annual food drive. So when you leave today, you're going to be giving a bag, fill it up with canned goods and food, and bring it back on Yom Kippur so that we can fill the food pantries that we support. That's so very, very important. And there's another gift that goes along with the sweetness of the sisterhood's apple and honey. And Cantor, what is that? I know you've prepared something special for us.
So some of you have come up to me and said, Cantor, can you sing the Oseh Shalom that I know? Or can you sing the Shalom Aleichem that I know? Yes, I can, and I will, and I have, I swear I have. But there's also lots of beautiful melodies that you may not have heard. So I thought that we should create a CD for you to have a little taste of Shabbat to take home with you. So in addition to your apples and honey, you'll be getting a CD that you can turn into MP3s if you like, or put into your car, and you'll have a little taste of Shabbat when you need it and when you want it.
We'll have Jewish giveaway Shabbat. What do you think?
Just like Oprah.
Right, just like Oprah. Only better, right? All right, our final song is Adon Olam, page 75. Following our final benediction, we're all going to be going out through the side doors this direction, apples and honey, and also the CD from the cantor, which is really, really special. Let's join together. Adon Olam, let's all rise. Blessed were you in coming to greet the new year with fullness of heart, with a sense of faith, of community, and spirit. May you go forth now and forevermore in your Jewish journey with a sense of pride and of mission. May God be with you, and may you find strength and faith and family and love. Good yontif, everyone.